Hello everyone, I'm the Saxy Gamer. Today we're here for yet another Civilization 6 Wonder Spotlight, where today we'll be taking a look at the Taj Mahal. The Taj Mahal is a wonder that is unlocked with the Humanism Civic, making it a Renaissance era, much like all of the other wonders that we've talked about recently. In order to get the inspiration for humanism, all that you have to do is recruit a great artist, so if you're going for a culture victory, chances are you will have done this probably multiple times by this point. If you're not going for a culture victory though, then chances are you probably haven't recruited a great artist. There's a chance that maybe you have if you've been building for some theater squares for a little bit of extra culture, but aside from that, for culture victories, you can definitely count on getting this inspiration, but elsewise, you probably shouldn't count on it. But either way, this wonder is pretty late in the game, so the inspiration isn't gonna, you know, make a huge difference between you being able to build the wonder versus not being able to build it. Once you research humanism, the building requirements for Taj Mahal are as follows. They are very simple, probably one of the simplest in the game, and that's just that it needs to be built next to a river. So I would assume that you probably have at least one river in your civilization somewhere. Hopefully it's in a good city where you're able to build Taj Mahal, because the production cost is 920 production, so you probably will want to be building this in a pretty beefy city. Otherwise, it's going to take you about 10 million years. But this is the same as all of the other Renaissance era wonders, except for which is the one that has higher production. I believe that it is Potola Palace, or maybe Potato Palace, whatever you want to call it. But either way, you know, in a good city, you're still looking at the typical 20 to 30 turns to build Taj Mahal. Now let's go ahead and get on to the actually interesting part of Taj Mahal, and that is its wonder bonuses. So there is only one that it has, and it's that it will provide +1 era score to all future historic moments that already provide 2 or more era score. So this is a bit of a mouthful, but really it's pretty simple. So if you were originally going to get, say, 2 era score from a for a historic moment, then after building Taj Mahal, instead of getting 2, you'll get 3, or, you know, pretty much whatever you would normally get, just add 1 to it as long as it originally would have provided 2. So this can be really good in the late game, just because a lot of the late game historic moments do provide 2 or more era score, some of them even quite a bit more than that, so being able to get +1 on those is really good for chaining together golden ages, and that's really one of the big reasons to build Taj Mahal, is because some of the late game dedication bonuses are quite good, so getting Taj Mahal makes it just a little bit easier to chain those together. So obviously +1, it's gonna have to, you know, you're gonna have to get a good number of historic moments already in order to get any significant bonus from Taj Mahal, so that is one of the things that is a little bit tricky about it. Is, you know, obviously if you're going to get any significant bonus from it, you have to be getting good era score anyways, so is it really, you know, all that worth it? And the answer to me is sometimes yes. A lot of the time, if you're really far ahead in the late game, you're probably going to be getting a ton of era score and you're going to be overshooting golden ages already, so for that reason, it's, you know, it's just kind of meh. But on those games where it is a bit of a close game and, you know, every little era score counts, then the Taj Mahal actually can be quite good, and this bonus is actually somewhat impactful. So now let's go ahead and rate the Taj Mahal. If you're new to the series, all that you really need to know here is that these ratings go on a 1 to 5 scale, with 1 being the worst and 5 being the best. So for its overall rating, I think that the Taj Mahal deserves 2. I really don't think that it's, most of the time, I don't think that it's that impactful of a wonder, for the reasons that I just previously described there, that honestly, if you're going to be having an era where you're getting a lot of, you know, +2, +3 historic moments anyways, then chances are you're not going to struggle too much to get a golden age or to push yourself into normal age, so getting one additionally on top of all of that, a lot of the time is, you know, not that insanely good. That being said, though, there are some cases where I do really like Taj Mahal, and a lot of the times it honestly can just be one of those, if you're ahead, it can make you even more ahead, just because the more and more of those historic moments that you get, the easier it is to just keep chaining together golden ages, which then, you know, at the farther and farther ahead you get, the more opportunities for historic moments there are, so it just makes it very easy to chain together golden ages. As far as its use cases are concerned, there are 2 of them. So for one of them, I guess it's kind of a use case. It's more so a synergy, but this is a really great thing that synergizes with both Heartbeat of Steam and 2 Arms. So those are I believe they're Industrial and Modern Era. Correct me if I'm wrong there, but dedication bonuses. And the reason that this is so good is because these dedication bonuses by default give 2 era score, and they're pretty easy to satisfy. So being able to get Taj Mahal with that makes it so you can get a lot of, instead of +2, you can get a lot of +3 historic moments instead, which really makes it easier to get into a normal and golden age in the next era. And then additionally, it's just very good for late game power spikes, because some of the dedication bonuses in the modern and, you know, the eras after that are actually quite good. Especially for culture victory, there's the one that gives you the extra tourism from national parks, which can be really, really good if you're going for a culture victory, because it can give you a huge boost to tourism, which is something that is very nice to have. As far as its difficulty rating is concerned, I think it deserves a 2. For whatever reason, the AI don't incredibly like Taj Mahal. They don't build it very often, so normally you don't have to compete that much with them in order to build it. And not to mention the fact that you will pretty much always be able to satisfy the building requirements, because all you need is a single tile that is next to river in your empire, and then you'll be able to build Taj Mahal. So if you don't have that, then, I'd be quite surprised. So for those reasons, I think it is very easy to build and thus deserving of the 2. And for its consistency rating, I think it deserves a 3. This is one of those wonders that is like, sometimes it's very consistent, sometimes it's not. Therefore it is kind of inconsistent in that way. But in a lot of games, you at least will get some bonus from Taj Mahal. There's pretty much no game that you won't get any bonus from it. It is kind of flexible in just how much bonus era score you'll get though. So for that reason, I think it deserves a 3 for its consistency rating. So thank you everyone for watching. I've been the Saxy Gamer. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to like. If not, feel free to dislike. If you're looking for some more Civilization VI content, feel free to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.